Somebody said you should have been preaching. I said, what are you talking about? I'm preaching for it. Most preachers preaching against it. That's all I understand. Thank you. I could have done a preacher. I could have had religion this very day. But women and whiskey took my spell away. I walked out the church choir in Anniston, Alabama, 1962, and started singing about women for money, and I never turn around. But I still feel everything I ever felt in my life. That's right. I know I gave him my best shot, and when you hear I'm gone, you all you can say is, well, he did his best.
Did my best. Forget the best. Time for rest.
I know we got another game we have to go play, and some of you may be wondering that, and I hope you are. And we don't want to mess up here because I'm old. I need a little rest time in the hotel room. My feet. I've been between two gigs. I'm going to do two gigs in one day. I mean, no, I'm telling you, I'm old as hell. You ain't got my birth certificate. You don't know nothing. Yeah, but at 65, my clock been around twice a normal person, okay? I started doing this in 1962, so, you know, 65 is like 165. Anyway, that's enough about me. Let's move on to you.
From the one.
We're old team.
Oh,
little family. Ain't that something? One of them fine little places where you can look across the room and see your ex old time used to be. Wearing that nice jacket you bought her, nice bracelets you bought her, diamond hair rags you bought her, wearing that pretty watch you bought her, and nice shoes with the sexy straps that you bought her. Most likely wearing them pretty drawers you bought her. And you can think to yourself, she cleans up pretty good. I don't know who she with today, but I will be buying her some of them low sodium potato chips. I don't know what makes me say crap like that. I'm sorry if I feel bad. I just get it. Well, that old clock on the wall says we gotta go and get ready for the next place, and we'll never forget this one. And I'm sure you'll see these two back here pretty soon, and you'll see us back here soon when we get here. Going on to the next place doesn't mean the end of something, it just means the next place. As always, you know, as long as you're still in the game, see. Once you step out the game, somebody will take your place. There's been many young men came along trying to take my place, but I just kept stepping, and they fell in behind me. Every now and then, one of them will scoot on around you, you know. He'll run out of gas because he didn't pace himself. It's an old turtle in the hair story. I see some cats that come along, and they open for me, and they got a big mouth full of much obliged, you know. Everything's good. Then a year later, I see them, and I'm opening for them, and they go, come on in, have a glass of this good wine. In my dressing room trailer, this is better wine than we had back when it was your dressing room trailer. And I go, yeah, but it's still just crappy wine in a crappy trailer. You ain't did nothing. And then about 2 years later, hell, there we are back again, even opening for me. And, you know, so what? What difference does it make? Am I wrong? What am I lying? Thank you. give it up for Joe Meyer, please. Old dear friend, ladies and gentlemen, for many years, talk about world class, one of the greatest bass players that ever lived. That's what it's all about right there. You hear that? Nathan James on the guitar.